The video arcade is down the street. Here we just sell small rectangular objects. They're called books. They require a little effort on your part and make no beep, 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 beeps. On your way, please.
I know books. I have 186 of them at home.
Ah, comic books.
No, I've read Treasure Island, The Last of the Mohicans, Wizard of Oz, Lord of the Rings, 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, Tarzan.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Come. Who are you running away from?
Just some kids from school.
Why?
They want to throw me in the garbage.
So why don't you give them a good punch in the nose?
Well, I don't know. What's that book about?
Oh, this is something special.
Well, what is it?
Look, your books are safe. While you're reading them, you get to become Tarzan or Robinson Crusoe.
But that's what I like about him.
Ah, but afterwards you get to be a little boy again.
What do you mean?
Listen. Have you ever been Captain Nemo? Trapped inside your submarine while the giant squid is attacking you.
Yes.
Weren't you afraid you couldn't escape?
But it's only a story.
That's what I'm talking about. The ones you read are safe.
And that one isn't?
Don't worry about it.
But you just said it was...
Forget about it. This book is not for you.
There's this kid, he dreams, his mom died, and you know, he's kind of sad about that, and he's not doing very well in school, he's getting bullied. And while he's running away from the bullies, he runs into this bookshop, and he finds this book called The NeverEnding Story. He sneaks into the school attic, opens the book, and starts reading it, and getting completely enwrapped in this story. And that book story is that there is this magical land, and there is a magical force destroying that land called the Nothing. And the only person who can stop the Nothing is the Empress, but she is very sick. So a young boy named Atreyu has to go on a quest to find a cure for the Empress. And one of my favorite things about this movie is actually the opening, where we learn about this kid. The way that his father and he have this conversation, what we get to learn about him and his past. And it's just the fact that they're able to make you care about this kid in just that short of a time. They have this one scene. It's something that just doesn't happen in movies that way anymore. And it's something that I love about 80s movies. You know, me being my age, I look at this movie and sometimes I think it's a little campy. But that's kind of the point. It's supposed to be this fun, simple adventure, because it's like it's for a kid, and you get to see the kid react to all this. And the kid is what really keeps you invested in this fantasy story. Because while the fantasy story is all silly and campy to us, that kid feels real. And there are some dark moments in this movie, and that's not something that happens in kids' movies anymore either. The scale between optimism and hopelessness in this movie is so insanely varied. One minute we'll be flying on the back of a dragon looking at this beautiful landscape, and the next, the world is ending. And the fact that they're able to make that work is a big credit to the movie. The puppet work in this movie is really excellent. All their faces are expressive, and it's this charming, fun thing. They make these characters come to life, and you know, the way they look, you know it's a puppet, but you're still attached to it. Example I'll give is the most iconic character from the movie, Falcor, a luck dragon. He's a dragon, but he kind of looks like a dog. And he's just this really cool, really laid-back guy who helps out our hero, and he's just great. And the way that his eyes move and all that, it all just makes him feel real, and it makes you feel an attachment to him. And there's all these really gorgeous landscapes, and there's so many shots where you just go, oh, that's a great shot. Oh, that's a great shot. And the sets, they look like sets, but you can tell there was effort and work put into those sets, and so it's charming. And it does evoke the feeling that you're in this fantastical place. It's great. And you know, it's this fantasy adventure story. There's plenty of great side characters that are charming and fun. You go to all these different environments and they're all varied and interesting. And the movie knows how to keep you invested. It knows how to make you want to continue on. It's charming. It's a good time. It knows how to get you invested in the characters, and it does things that movies just don't do anymore. It's got this great, wonderful soundtrack, a great theme song, and you will leave with a smile on your face. I'm gonna give The NeverEnding Story an A-.
When do I begin?
Now. And you must hurry, Atreyu, for nothing grows stronger every day. Take this. Wears the Orin, speaks for the Empress. It will guide and protect you.
A creature of darkness also began his quest.